As LEDs dominate the artificial world of lighting, there are some common misconceptions we'd like to address and clarify. The first misconception is that LEDs are expensive to purchase.
When purchasing lighting, the cost per tube is usually the biggest deciding factor. But if we switch that thought process to how much you spend lighting the tube, this number holds a bigger value. LED tubes are made of high-quality components. Therefore, this does increase the cost. But they require less wattage, and they also require lower maintenance, and they do have a longer life cycle. Therefore, the total value of an LED tube is significantly better than a fluorescent or an incandescent tube.
Now, we've also heard that LED technology is the same as conventional lighting technology. Is this true?
This is definitely a myth, as LEDs consist of two lead semiconductors that produce visible light when current passes through them. In addition, a yellow phosphorus layer creates the visible white light that we can see with our eyes. Another component that differentiates an LED tube is the heatsink, which regulates the temperature and prevents the tube from overheating. Conventional lighting, like fluorescents and incandescent lightings, do not use heatsinks. With energy focuses tubes, heatsinks are incorporated in every single tube by the aluminum backing. Incandescent bulbs produce light using electricity to heat a metal filament until it becomes white hot. Incandescents produce heat in addition to light. In fact, incandescents release 90% of their energy as heat. It actually serves as a better heater than a producer of light. In a fluorescent or CFL lamp, an electric current flows between electrodes at each end of a tube containing gases. This reaction provides ultraviolet light and heat. The ultraviolet light is transformed into visible light when it strikes the phosphor coating on the side of the bulb.
Do I need to dispose of LEDs like hazardous material? Once I retrofit my facility, how do I go about recycling the TLEDs?
LED tubes do not contain any mercury, and most tubes are compliant to RoHS, which has extreme restrictions on how much lead and other hazardous material are included in the makeup of the tube. Therefore, LED tubes do not have to be disposed like common hazardous waste. Instead, you can dispose of them regularly, or you can also send them back to your vendor for proper disposal.
The next myth I've heard is that you can't integrate controls with LED products.
Integrated controls can be used by LED products, as long as that LED product utilizes a 0 to 10 volt dimming feature, or if that LED product is installed in a direct fit mode that uses a dimming ballast. A lot of customers will want to use an integrated control because they want to comply to a certain regulation, like California Title Code 24, or they want total control of their system.
I read online that the blue light from LEDs can cause you to lose sleep. Is this true or is this a myth?
This one is sort of true. And to explain this, I do have to talk about melatonin. Melatonin is a chemical that can be found in the gland of your brain. The higher the melatonin, the more sleepy you feel. The brighter the light, or the higher the color temperature of your light, the cooler or bluer the light will appear. So by assumption, the cooler, bluer light will suppress the amount of melatonin in your system, when in reality, any light is going to keep you awake. It's a good assumption to say the bluer the light you're exposed to, the less sleepy that you'll feel. So it's a good practice to lower the brightness on your smart devices, dim the lighting, or turn off the TV before you go to bed.
There are many more clarifications of LED myths, and you can find them by going to our website at energyfocus.com. Find out how Energy Focus can enlighten and inspire you, or comment in the comment box below with your questions or comments. Thank you for watching, and remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel.